to rejoice.
Oh, yes.
Yes, sir.
Amen. We do give honor to God, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the head of our life, and to the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
That rest, room, and abide henceforth, now, and forevermore. Amen. We bless God for our presider, who's doing an awesome job, Pastor Tyson.
Amen.
We bless God for her. Of course, in the order in which we have here, of course, our annual bishop. We thank God for Bishop Willie T. Thomas. And his cabinet. We bless God for, of course, Bishop Gorham, who is, amen, one of the fathers of this church. Amen. And to Apostle Edwards, we bless God for you. Amen. We thank God for all of the ministry, anybody else that is here. Amen. All of the pastors, ministers, elders, amen, saints of God, and friends. We thank God for my very dear friend, amen, Pastor Worsley. God bless your heart. We love you so much, and we thank God for you, one of your awesome women of God. We thank God for all of you, God's people. Amen. All of you that I know to call, and amen, I did not call, and pray to the Lord. We thank God for this family, and we bless the Lord for all of the ones that have communicated with us and continue. I feel like what I would consider, amen, a step pastor in this atmosphere.
Jesus.
Y'all can't step down the road. Amen. But thank God for the Father being in this house that birthed all these children. Oh, awesome. Grown folk. I got a lot too, Doc, but amen. I'm thankful to God for being here.
Amen.
And I promise you, I will not be before you long. We thank God. Amen. I got to say this to this family, to his wife.
Amen.
To his wife.
Amen.
I said to his wife.
Amen.
We bless God for, amen, Elders Davis, and to all of the ones that are here, to the brothers and sisters and siblings and everybody that have been a part of this setting, to his children, we bless God for them, amen.
Amen.
We thank God for what he is doing. Now, the reason why I am kind of going a little bit slow, because it's hot in here. And I really want to take this robe off, but I'm not going to do it now because I probably won't be here too much longer. But I am thankful to God for all of you for this homegoing celebration, to our choir that are singing on the Lerome of God. Amen. And we ask God's blessings upon each and every one of you. Now, as I begin this message, I am thankful to God for Pastor Lerome Davis. As I forestated, he started preaching. He preached his initial sermon in 76, was it? 78, okay. All right, I saw this. And, amen. But he's done an awesome job. His journey has been challenging, but he kept on going.
All right.
The thing that I love about Pastor Lerome, every time he came here, he would sit right over there, amen. He would not move until he got to talk to me. And then he didn't talk out here. Most of the time we went back here in the pastor study, as pastors do, and we communicated, we sat down, we talked, amen. And I'm just so thankful to God of his humility. Sometimes you have to understand, saints of God, some people, amen, humility is not humility.
Amen.
You can tell people when they're real or when they're not. And what happens is sometimes, amen, when I looked at him and I sensed how he was so humble, amen, you didn't have to worry about or think about where he was coming from. Amen. Because what you see is what you got.
All right.
Amen. That's the reason why I love, and anybody hear me, amen, I love Maya Angelou, because she always said, if anybody ever show you who they are,
go ahead with it.
Believe them. And you know, some people, amen, they'll show you who they are, and then when you tell them, then you ask a question, are you okay? Well, did I do something to you? No, I just don't feel good. No, what you showed me,
all right,
is what.
Amen.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I'm sorry. Y'all didn't catch that. Because some of y'all ain't done rolled your eyes at me already. But anyway, we pray, Lord, for you. Amen. As I first said, we thank God for this family. We bless God for you, to his wife, and all of you. Amen. All of this family. Amen. We know, and let's deal with the elephant in the room, and the bull that was in the china cabinet.
Come on now.
Y'all can sit down the road. Amen. We understand that we love Sister Shirley, but God had allowed us to know that when God took her home, he gave him another. See, y'all don't like talk about that. I preach to y'all because the bottom line is I'm real. I don't play games. And when God gives you, the Bible said, if any man that findeth a wife, findeth a good thing. Amen. Amen. So we're thankful to God. Now, as I first said, I'm blessed with the Lord. Amen. Y'all can, after this show, I can go on and pray the Lord. Thank you, God. Amen. And if we go into the Word of God, you can throw everything you want after that, but let me go into the Word of God. Amen. The Gospel according to St. Luke, the second chapter. Amen. As we journey down this road, we want to do this Homegoing celebration. And I pray that, amen, Pastor Ron Davis had touched somebody in this house, that when you think of his life, you ought to give God praise. The reason why, when you think about his life, you ought to give God praise is because he never gave up. He never lost. I'll leave that down below. Amen. So y'all better. Amen. We will go into the Word of God, the Gospel according to St. Luke. Amen. The second chapter. And we're going to begin at the 25th verse, as it begins by saying, "And behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. And the same man was just and devout, waiting for the consolation of Israel. And the Holy Ghost was upon him. And it was that was revealed unto him by the Holy Ghost that he should, watch this, not see death before he had seen the Lord Christ. And he came by the Spirit into the temple. And when the parents brought in the Christ, the child Jesus, to do to him after the customs of the law, then took him up in his arms and blessed God and said, Lord, now let us thou the servant depart. I can go now.
All right, well,
in peace.
Amen.
Just give me a few minutes and I promise you that I'll get out of here. The message that we want to highlight in this Homegoing celebration is, amen, I need, for those of you that's not family, that's everybody, y'all, all y'all family, amen. I need for you to look at somebody and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
He's seen enough.
He's seen enough.
He's seen enough. As I forestated, as I was getting ready to think about how this message was going to go forth, I said to myself, God, this man of God has been so inspirational in all of our lives, and he lived a wonderful life. He walked through the avenues of pastoralship. He walked through the avenues of deaconship. He walked through the avenues of committing to ministry. Sometimes when I was listening, amen, to Pastor, as she was standing firm and she was presiding on today, she made the statement, amen, sometimes, you know, you do what you want to do as a pastor, I mean, as a member, amen, and then you don't do because, you know, you have your own issues, but you do what you want to do. But I come to let you know, sometimes when that happens, amen, as a servant, if you do that as a servant, amen, you reap what you sow. And so what goes on is that if you treat a man, amen, your pastor a certain way, if God elevates you, you want to get the same thing, amen, that you gave to somebody else. Now when I look at, amen, Pastor Lerome Davis, he was humble, whether he was in leadership or whether he was serving. Because some people think that it's my title that makes me who I am. Baby, it's your character that makes you who you are. Amen. If your character is not in line, you can have every title in the world. Amen. We've been teaching in Bible study. Amen. And we was talking about, amen, the difference between fruits and gifts. And to those of you that don't know it, I'll give you that analogy. Amen. The difference between a fruit and a gift is that gifts, of course, are given. Amen. That means they're given without repentance. If I give you a gift, I always say this, if I give you a gift, say I give you, amen, a new suit. Amen. I'm going to talk to the doctor here because you cleaned up. You cleaned up. Amen. If I give you a suit, amen, and you leave here with that suit and you go down the road, and the suit that I gave you, you throw it in the ditch. Amen. It's wonderful, amen, because I'm giving you the gift. But if I see how you treat the gift, I'm not going to give you another gift. Lord, I feel like preaching it here. That's what goes on, is that God gives the body a gift. But then we find the fruit. That's the problem with the church today. It's because we don't understand the difference between a gift and a fruit. The gift are given, but you got to work for the fruit. I'm still here. Amen. How do you know that? Because, saints of God, amen, you go out there, amen, and plant a tree. You can plant that tree and leave it all you want to. But there's going to come a time where you have to do some work on that tree in order to manifest the fruit that's needed. Amen. It's not that that fruit or that tree is not what you planted it to be, but there's got to be some work. Here because, saints of God, I look at Pastor Lerome Davis and that he always shown me fruit. I don't know about you. I know we love people that always want to come in here and tell you how gifted I am, how anointed I am, and how my title tells me that I'm pastoring all these churches and I got all of this going on for me and everybody's looking up to me. But I came to let you know that Pastor Lerome Davis was not worried about whether you saw him or not. He treated you the very same. Amen. It didn't matter whether you came to his church or not. As a matter of fact, I talked to his wife and they said, amen, I would preach one, I would, and then somebody else preach another, and then if he felt like preaching,
Jesus,
he would preach. Amen. In other words, I'm going to do it until I die. until I die. And that's the reason why when we look at him, we see the longevity in his life. But if you look at anybody, let's look at the journey that's going on in this setting, because a lot of young people are leaving here. There's a lot of people now that people don't understand. And it did not just start. Because the Joan of Arc, amen, I know everybody talk about her and listen about her and talk about how she made a stand. But she died at 19. Amen. And Mother Sister Teresa, amen, when we look at this Sister Teresa, amen, she started out and she asked to be in leadership, but she died at 25. Wow. And can I go here? Oldest Raymond, I know y'all love this because, amen, I see some of the seniors and I am what you call, amen, a baby boomer. I remember sitting on the dock of the bay. Amen. But some of them don't understand that, amen, that our oldest Raymond ship floated off when he was 26. He was a young man. And, amen. As a matter of fact, Martin Luther King and Malcolm X, amen, died at the age of 39. That means that God has no respect for a person. People are leaving here at young age. But when I look at this man of God and see the servitude that he had, he said, look at here, I'm going to stay until I die. But during the journey of him staying here, he saw a lot of things. See, the thing that you got to understand, it's good to stay here for a long time, but God will reveal to you some things that you have to apprehend so you can help somebody else. Can I preach it here or should I quit? Amen. And so therefore what we learn during this journey is that God showed us, amen, that when you walk in the avenue of seeing enough, that means God is letting you know that there's going to be a time that enough is enough. Why did I say that? Because, amen, even in Mark the 4th chapter, we find that Jesus went to the disciples 3 times. And he looked at them and said, can't you just stay awake? Amen. 1 hour. But the third time he said, look, y'all sleep on. See, that's going to be a time when as God's going to let you know, just sleep on. It doesn't matter what folks say. Now the time is for you to sleep on. How do you know that? Because, saints of God, when enough is enough. Amen. You have to journey through the Bible to see many that went through challenges in their lives. They have made up in their mind that no matter what goes on, amen, I'm going to do what the Lord has called me to do. I don't feel like giving up right now. I don't feel like throwing in the towel right now. But just as long as God gives me strength in my body, I am determined to do what he called me to do. That's the reason why when I look at Pastor Lerome Davis, when he was pastoring over there. Oh my God, I feel like preaching a little bit. Over there at Patrick Chapel. The thing that I love about it, amen, when he was here at Dilda's Chapel, as a matter of fact, I think he was a president of the choir. Amen. Can I preach it here? He was the president of the choir. And during the time of him being the president of the choir, he had one of those powerful leaders that let you know, In other words, he let you know 144,000. Amen. In other words, let you know I'm going to be a part of that journey. I'm going to be a part of that significant atmosphere. To let you know, amen, amen, I look. Y'all ain't catching it. I said, I look. What did you see? Y'all ain't catching it. I look. You see, y'all ain't caught it yet. But the time had come where, being that he was over this choir, he made up in his mind, if I can't sing, if I can't, amen, go forth and pray, I'm going to sing unto the glory of God. Now the time had come, saints of God, during the time of seeing enough, sometimes you get to the place of saying, God, I can't take no more. Amen. What do you mean by that? Amen. If you look at all of these apostles and these prophets him. To those of you that have read your Bible or did your study, all of the folks that stoned him threw their coats in the midst of Paul. Y'all ain't preaching. Amen. And Paul was holding and watching what was going on. And I heard in the midst of that, Mark said, look at him. I know I'm not the wisest person in the bunch, but I want you to know, in spite of being dragged into pieces, I made up in my mind, I will not, I refuse to give up. Look at somebody and say, I won't give up now. Now the time has come. I'm not going to stay too much longer.
Pastor Davis, you gone.
Pastor Davis is
here.
Pastor Davis is not interested in coming back.
Go ahead, man.
There's three things I need to tell y'all. The very first thing is that people that leave us are happier than people that they left behind.
Go ahead.
You can say all you want to.
All right.
But if you were to ask him, I've been through all of this. This body have not acted right.
Jesus.
But he said, look here, I got a new body.
Yeah.
So therefore, if you were to ask him and say, look, Pastor, is there, we want you to come back? He said, all right. I'm not going coming back to that coronavirus. I'm not coming back to what's going to happen in November. I'm not coming back to these backbiting folks that go to church and act like they love you. I'm not going back, y'all ain't. Amen. And folk that jump high but ain't living up, and I'm not going back. I'm not going back to the folk that look at me funny. They act like they love me, but they ain't studying me. I refuse to go back, because right now I feel. So that's the first thing you must understand. And the second thing you must understand is that death don't hurt. Life does. Us to go somewhere.
Go ahead.
He left us to go to someone.
Yeah.
Why go to a better place?
Go ahead, Pastor.
And if I go,
come on.
Pastor Davis has been an awesome,
yes, sir,
awesome friend.
Yes.
Mind you, I didn't come in personal, but Pastor Davis has been a jewel in the body of Christ. Pastor Davis has been a soldier.
Oh, yes.
In the army of the Lord.
Amen. All right.
Every preacher stand if you know. Bishop Gorham have poured out so many pastors, apostles, bishops, leaders, evangelists. And the thing that I've learned is that Pastor Lerome Davis, out of all of the people that have come from under him, he never wish-washed in what he was doing. He knew who God called him to be.
Oh, yeah. Amen. Amen.
So he said, look, I'm a pastor, and I'm going to stand firm.
Amen.
Because some people feel like if I'm being a pastor, I need a whole bunch of folk.
Come on
now. I'd rather pastor five folks than none the Lord.
Come on.
All right. All right.
Then the pastor 10,000 devils.
Go ahead, pastor.
Let the church say amen.
Yes, Lord.
Those of you that will, telling you, I'm not going to fall out up here. It's hot. So everybody stand, hold your hands for this soldier. Come pray. Will you come pray?
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Let's bow our heads.
Yes.
Lord, this is a prayer of thanks right now. Not going to ask you anything else, but now we thank you, God. What you've already done. God, we thank you for sending this soldier on the battlefield. We love you, God, for sending it in our lives. How you use them now through the years. For this, God, we thank you. God, help us, God, to be more like you. For understanding. For burn a barrier. We need you, God. Bless this family, God. Those that are left behind, God. Let always be a remembering of this great man of God. God bless the grandchildren, the great-grandchildren. Especially God bless the wife, brothers and the sister. Oh God, I know you can. God, I know you will. Bless this congregation. And always remember the work that he done. Let the work that he done speak for him. Jesus' name we pray.